Hey, and welcome to my channel, Code with Chew. And this is my Tailwind tutorial series. Hey, so I just wanted to give a small intro for Tailwind CSS. So it's a pretty cool CSS framework. It's built completely out of these utility classes. And it gives us the ability to transform our HTML elements over here into UI components, all without having to write CSS. So you don't have to leave your HTML markup or your HTML document over here. Now that makes it very popular with the front-end frameworks like Vue or React setups. So what it doesn't give you is predefined components. So you're not going to get buttons or cards or alerts similar to other CSS frameworks that have a specific design system. And if you want out of that design system, you have to reverse engineer or override a lot of the styles to achieve what you want. So that's what's different about Tailwind is there's no design system. It's unopinionated, so you don't have to follow anything. And basically, you have a lot of flexibility and freedom on how your UIs look. And if there's no utility class that supports what you want to achieve, you can customize one. So it gives you a lot of freedom, a lot of flexibility. You're not pigeonholed into a design system or anything like that. So that's kind of it in a nutshell. Why don't we head over to our code editor and see it in action. Let's take a look how we can create a component here. So I'm gonna create this a button similar to that. So let's move that to the side here. And let's create a button here. Href, and let's do click me, save that. Let's serve this up and see what that looks like first. So you got this button here in the middle. It's pretty basic, it's just black. So let's add some utility classes to it. So we can do, let's give it a background of teal 500. Let's give it a text color, white. Let's make the text or font bold. And it's a little tight there, so let's give it some padding. So let's do a PY of 2 and a PX on the x-axis of 4. Let's add some rounded corners, so rounded there, and let's give the text size some crazy size here. Okay, cool. So now we have this button here. Let's add a pseudo class, so for hover, so we can give it eg teal, make it a little darker, to 700. So when we hover over it, there's a little bit of feedback. Okay, cool. So very quickly, without having to leave our HTML document here, or our HTML markup, we're able to convert that basic black text into a button component. We'll be building a website throughout this tutorial series. I wanted to go over some of the prerequisites. So you should know some basic or general knowledge of how a website is built or just the website structure. You should have some basic knowledge of HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And if you don't, you may find it very difficult to be able to follow along our videos. I do break it down step by step, but you still may find it difficult. Now, if you don't know any of this stuff, then I would say come to a site like W3 Schools, and they have tutorials on each one of these languages. Now I would say CSS is probably the biggest one, as our tutorial series is about Tailwind CSS, and all of their utility classes are based off of CSS's properties. I would focus also, I'd definitely focus on, if you're gonna skip some of this stuff, at the CSS Flexbox, responsive web design, and CSS grids, as those are the biggest parts of our tutorial series. And I'll post up a link for all three of these into the video description down below. It's required that we have Node.js installed onto our computers. We'll be utilizing Node Package Manager, NPM, to install some packages. So if you don't have Node installed, or if you don't know if you have Node installed, open up a command line window, a terminal window, and type in Node, N-O-D-E, space dash V for version. Type that, and a version number should pop up. If you have a version number, then that's great. You don't have to do anything else. You have Node installed. If you don't have a version number, or your version is out of date, if it's in the 13s, 12s, 11s, maybe it's a good idea to update the latest version. So you can go to nodejs.org, download that, install it. It may take a minute or two. Once that's completed, come back to your terminal window, type in the same command again, node-v, get a version number, and you should be good to go. You may need to restart your computer, I'm not sure, and just run, come back and open up a terminal window and type that command line again, just to make sure. Okay, so if that's all good, then you're good to go. If you don't have a code editor, I recommend Visual Studio Code. It's a great editor, has a lot of extensions, it's free to download, has dark mode. Basically, it's a good editor to be using. I also like it because it has a built-in terminal, so I can go like this and start coding in here, and it syncs up to where your project folder is, so you don't have to have a separate terminal window open with that's in the same directory. Also, benefit is we'll be using two extensions, Live Server. And this will help us serve up any local HTML files. And we'll be using this one here, Tailwind CSS IntelliSense. So this one will help us with auto completion when we're typing in our classes for the utilities. So yeah, so I wanted to do those two things. If you're not using Visual Studio Code, I'm not sure if your editor of choice will have these two things. Maybe I'll have something different or something equivalent. But yeah, I'll be using Visual Studio Code if you want to follow along with that. I wanted to give you guys a preview of the website we'll be building using Tailwind CSS throughout this tutorial series. So we have this fake headphone brand here. In a full screen, full width layout that's showcasing its product. So throughout this tutorial series, we'll be using a bunch of different Tailwind utility classes. So we'll be looking at, over here, typography. We'll be looking at width and heights. We'll be looking at some subtle animations here. And here on the navigation, from transparent to opaque. We'll be looking at different layout systems like Flexbox here and some CSS grids here. And it showcases some other products here. We'll be looking at component building here. And we have a footer down here. And it also uses responsive design. So if we go here and inspect, we can take a look at what it looks like here on mobile as well. So here you can see that it looks more like a card style on these two elements, or these two components here. We also have a mobile menu up here. So not everything on this website uses Tailwind. We have some vanilla JavaScript that controls this and the scroll to the top here. And also our navigation that we have that triggers this. So I hope you guys are excited about building this website, and let's continue on. I have my source files hosted on my GitHub account over here, CodeWithChu. I'll post this link into the video description. I've also set up a different branch for each one of the videos over here. And you can go over here and click here to download the code. If you know how to clone, then you can clone the full repo over here and follow along that way. So that wraps up the intro. In the next tutorial, we'll be looking at how to set up and install Tailwind CSS. And I hope to see you there. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed the content, and please leave a comment down below. And don't forget to hit the like button. If you want to stay up to date, get notified about my latest videos and tutorial series, you can subscribe to the channel by clicking over here.